We're doing so to drive home the contrast. And that's where India comes in. Does Narendra Modi fit in this pantheon of dictators? Logically, he does not, because he's a freely elected leader of a democracy. While regarded as a strong leader, driven by a vision of India and less willing to compromise, Modi has been able to raise the bar in terms of what the public can expect of a politician. By all accounts, he works 24/7, he rarely takes a vacation, he travels extensively, he is known to get involved in detailed planning of the itinerary of visiting international leaders. He's raised India's international profile. The world is taking notice when India stands up. When India stood up to China during the Doklam standoff last year, it made international headlines. And then again, when India boycotted China's celebration of One Belt, One Road, that's a project India has refused to join despite the pressure. Narendra Modi tends to centralize power in the Prime Minister's office. Under him, the PMO functions as a mini secretariat, overseeing key decisions in practically every ministry. That may leave his ministers out on a limb, but none complain. Modi is the first Prime Minister to speak out on how Indians live and behave. And that's very, very significant, a significant part of his politics. He kicked off the Swachh Bharat campaign, determined that Indians must not live in squalor, must be educated about hygiene. The only way to go about this is to talk about it publicly. He's been critical of how Indians treat their young, especially the girls, the discrimination they face. Hence the Beti Bachao campaign launched by the PM. Despite the constraints of a democracy, he has helmed key economic reforms. Demonetization, for one, was messaged as a blow against black money. The goods and services tax, or GST, was driven by the vision of one Indian market. Digital India was to propel India into the internet age. Make in India is intended to boost manufacturing and create jobs. This is all work in progress, of course. It has been hamstrung by the missed opportunities of the past. He abolished the planning commission, but the Niti Aayog is yet to come into its own. The process of getting government out of the business of running PSUs, public sector undertakings, is yet to take off in any meaningful way. Perhaps the privatization of Air India will show the way. Narendra Modi is yet to begin reform of the bureaucracy or transform the manner in which defense and strategic planning is done in this country. To Modi's advantage is the disarray the opposition is in and the lack of any credible leader with a national image. Narendra Modi has time to reform and transform India. He's a global voice, and all of this without the dictatorial advantages of his global peers.